À l'occasion du 70e anniversaire de la Déclaration universelle des droits de l'homme, j'ai proposé à Michelle Bachelet, nouvelle haut-commissaire aux droits de l'homme des Nations Unies, ancienne présidente du Chili, de venir devant le conseil municipal de la ville de Genève recevoir une résolution de soutien du conseil municipal unanimement votée pour marquer l'attachement de Genève à l'importance de ce texte universel qui nous concerne toutes et tous. Et j'ai le grand plaisir de l'accueillir, elle a accepté de répondre à nos questions.
So very happy to have you here.
Oh, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Votre mandat en tant que haut-commissaire débute au moment du 70e anniversaire de la Déclaration universelle des droits de l'homme. Comment appréhendez-vous une fonction si complexe?
Well, first of all, I think that I can bring to my job the experience that I have had in my life in terms of working during dictatorship in an NGO, supporting children's rights. I am a pediatrician, so they were my patients. Their parents were either in jail, whether tortured, whether killed or missing. Being the voice of the voiceless, but also being able to think in new strategies how to engage government to do the right thing. Now we're celebrating the 70th anniversary of the Human Rights Universal Declaration. And even though we have had progress, many countries include the principles in constitution, in national law, we still see a lot of violation of human rights in many parts of the world. And we all see conflicts that are terrible in many parts of the world. So I think this is a job that never ends. And while I'm here, I will do my best to improve them.
Vous avez été la première femme en Amérique latine à occuper le poste de ministre de la Défense, deux fois présidente du Chili et première directrice exécutive de ONU Femmes. Tenant compte de toutes ces expériences, quel est votre tout majeur?
As Minister of Defense, of course, I was in charge of this defense of the country, but also I tried to support women in the armed forces to get bigger positions, to have the same opportunities. And also in UN Women, I was working on gender issues, on women's issues, women's rights. And as a president, every time I was there, my program of government was on social protection and how to expand people's rights, the workers' rights, how we ensure quality education for everyone. Because for me, the important thing in any place is to fight against inequalities, to try to advance to a country with more prosperity, but prosperity for all, where dignity, justice, and human rights are promoted, respected. So in that sense, in my whole life, I've been dealing with this, with human rights in different levels, in different moments, but always in human rights.
Les droits humains sont intimement corrélés. Droits civils, politiques, économiques, sociaux, culturels, mais aussi environnementaux. Comment allez-vous intégrer les mesures pour le climat à vos priorités?
It is a priority, but not theoretically, because it's based on my own experience. As President of the Republic, we did a lot of things in terms of protecting the environment, protecting the oceans. We do believe that climate change is a reality, and it will affect people's rights. So that's why I am going to participate in Marrakesh on a side event on climate change, migration, and human rights, and also in Katowice in Poland during the conference on climate change. And on the other hand, I am part of a commission, an international commission on adaptation. I'm one of the commissioners. So I will participate also on how do we incorporate the context and the human rights approach in the climate change, and particularly in the plan of climate action. Because it's not about talking, it's about doing things. We need to talk. We need to make advocacy, but we need to do concrete things.
Genève est une ville multiculturelle, capitale de la paix et des droits humains, symbole de prospérité et de démocratie. Vous avez un parcours exceptionnel. Genève peut-elle vous surprendre?
I don't know. I haven't been so long yet here to know, but it might surprise me because I haven't been everywhere yet. So I might know things that I don't know yet. I'm sure there will be hidden places that I would love to know.